Oh, another wonderful day in the winter wonderland. I think I might turn today into an office day. What is going on out there? Well, just finished snowing. Gotta get that shovel out again. And now it's starting to get warm and windy, and it's raining. To which it's going to freeze tonight at minus 20 and then snow again. What can I say? Let's go check some bees. A little bit warm in the shed today. Starting to smell the bees in here. When's the last time I've been in this shed? I don't remember. Let's see what we have. We have some bearding. I have a feeling I'm going to be punished today walking the aisles, but for the purposes of letting everybody see what's going on and to satisfy my own curiosity, I want to see if these girls are bearding. I want to see if I can see bees. I want to see if I can see any spotting on the fronts like that. That's not too bad, but I just want to see the condition. Look at the bees on the floor. Time for a sweep. This is what I'm smelling. Oh, look at the bees down here. Whoa. We have drop. How much drop do we have? A good layer. You know, pretty solid layer, half inch of bees. Oh, my babies. Are there any bees left in these boxes? Here's another one. That's not good. Hate seeing that. We're halfway through February, and this is when we start seeing it. Stress. Oh, that's a lot of dead bees. And no wonder. I haven't been in this shed for quite a while. It's been very cold. And the shed has been keeping very nice and tight at 2 degrees, 4 degrees. It hasn't strayed off that too much. And I've been more so staying out of here just to give myself a break from my little babies. But also because I wanted to keep the shed pretty much undisturbed as I try to follow through with my overall intent of this building. Just keep these bees state of, they don't go dormant, but just trance. I like to think of it as them going into a trance as they manage all the conditions within their boxes themselves, whether it be humidity or carbon dioxide or whatever's going on in those little boxes. The less disturbance, the better, as they maintain the conditions around that winter cluster. And me walking around and breathing on them, stirring them up, just doesn't do any good. It's like, I think of it as like someone waking me up in the middle of a nice long sleep. It's like, piss off. See, I'm kind of stirring them up a little bit just by speaking, just by being here. And they're like, just leave us alone already. Is it time to go out yet? If not, then get out of here. I'll be like, all right, it's not time for work yet. Lots on the floor. This is going to be more in one wheelbarrow. So this sensor is reading 7 for good reason. Yay, 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 yay. I'm not complaining about seeing the bees. I just, oh, I sure hope. We put a lot of attention into packing these colonies full of syrup. I hope they have enough. Ouch. That one stung. So many bees. That's condensation from my vent. So with all the cold air coming in, this lasts forever. These vents, I imagine, are all frosted up. And now with this influx of warm air, well, the frost is melting. I'm not seeing any condensation issues. Oh, speak of the devil. There's one. So this one is not managing the moisture inside properly. I would say that they're probably a smaller colony. I'm just going to pop the lid. Just allow a little bit more airflow out of that one. Typically I'd see more condensation issues on this side of the shed because of that cold air coming in. But I'm not seeing any. There's a runny hive. That's not a good sign. They are very unsettled. They're seeing the white light and they're just like, ah! So I'm gonna get away from them. That's typically what we see in March if they're in for too long. Just very unsettled, runny. But I'm not seeing too much spotting. Like this one, looks like the bees have dropped on that one. Who knows what's going on inside. It was a good colony. There's not enough bees in this hive to kick those dead bees out the front, so something's going on in there. Oh, and the stress. Those runny bees, I hate seeing runny bees like that. But I'm not seeing much of it. If the shed is warm, I mean like we're 7 degrees in here, and for all the bearding I'm seeing, the nests are very calm and collected. Just a bit of disturbance in the white light and my breath as I speak. So, but there is running. This is what I mean about my disturbance. Just gets them stirred up when they start running all over the place and onto the floor. But that settles me down a little bit when I see calm, collected bees. Oh, the stress. This is why I gotta stay out of these sheds, because what good is it doing me just to see a hint of stress like that? It's not doing me any good whatsoever. It is what it is. What am I gonna do about it? Okay. I just want to see my nukes. This might punish me. It's a very narrow aisle. Oop. I'm not going to make it down here alive. Yeah, this shed is sure worked up. No, they're not worked up. They're just easily disturbed. Being just a little bit too warm. Nukes are looking alright. If you get a focus. Lots of dead bees on the floor. So what does that really mean? I don't know. This could mean that they're just big colonies. Natural processes happening within the nests. So as long as they keep saying good things, then I'll just bank on that. Nice and calm. Alright, see the canola honey? Thank you, Mother Nature. Okay, I'm gonna get out of here because I'm being tagged. What I'm seeing is favorable with hints of stress. And that is expected. So with the temperature at, so let me double check. .7 down the aisles, 6.2 within the shed. So we have a lot of airflow coming into the shed, and it's just the difference is the inability to instantly mix my air because of, you all know, my conditions within the shed. My mixing capacity isn't quite what it should be because I use ceiling fans. So that is why we have a difference between the inside and the outside. And we have some big colonies in the middle of my shed pumping out the heat. But those box fans are doing their job. Good night, babies. Beekeeper out.